Today we are going to find characteristic equation, eigenvalues, and the corresponding eigenvalues for the given matrix. Okay, this is the problem number 2 from eigenvalues and eigenvectors chapter. And the given matrix is one unit matrix 3 by 3. First we have to find characteristic equation. Okay, to find characteristic equation we are having formula, that is mod A minus lambda I equal to 0. Okay, A value is given matrix and I is identity matrix. Okay, after putting those values in this formula, what we'll get means 1 minus lambda 1 1 1 1 minus lambda 1 1 1 1 minus lambda equal to 0. Here we are going to find delta of this equation, so that what I'll get means minus lambda cube plus 3 lambda square plus 0 lambda plus 0 equal to 0. Here minus lambda cube plus 3 lambda square equal to 0. Now I'm shifting this 3 lambda square this side, so that minus minus get cancelled. Now lambda equal to 3 comma 0 comma 0. Now we got characteristic equation. Now we're gonna substitute these equations in the above matrix and we're gonna find eigenvalues. Okay, case 1. Eigenvectors corresponding to lambda equal to 3. Okay, we have to substitute in place of lambda 3. Okay, what we'll get means minus 2 1 1 1 minus 2 1 1 1 minus 2. Now what we have to do means we just need to put into x equal to 0. Okay, here we have to use row operations and we have to make this matrix as what we did in echelon form, right? We have to make these digits as 0, then upper row has to be, at least one element has to be 0. Okay, what we did in echelon form, we have to do the same thing here, only row operations here also, only row operations. Okay, first I'm applying row operation, that is shifting R1 with R2, so I'll get 1 here. Okay, here 1 minus 2 1 minus 2 1 1. Here I'll get 1 1 minus 2 to x equal to 0. Okay, now I want to make this digit as 0 and this one as 0. Further, what I'm doing means I'm applying row operation. R2 gives R2 plus 2R1 and R3 gives R3 minus R1. So that what I'll get means first row remains same, 1 minus 2, 1. Here I'll get 0 minus 3, 3, 0, 3 minus 3 into x equal to 0. Here next I'm applying row operation for the third row. There third row now I need to make this one as 0. For that R3 gives R3 minus R2. Okay, 1 minus 2, 1, 0, 0, minus 3, 3, 0, 0. X equal to X, Y, Z. Okay, X, Y. If you remember, we did in our 10 plus 2 homogeneous equations, we find out those all, no? Same thing here also, same principle or same. Okay, let z equal to k1, we are assuming that. Okay, here what I'm going to do means here we have to do like this x, and here x, you have to multiply this with x, here with y, and here with z. So that what I'll get means x minus 2y plus z equal to 0. I am substituting z value k1, x minus 2y plus k1 equal to 0. Here I am putting like this, and I am taking second one. Here multiply with x, x value going to be 0, and minus 3y plus 3z equal to 0. Okay, here I am going to substitute z value so that I will get y value, then that value I am going to substitute here. Okay, minus 3y plus 3k1 equal to 0. Here minus 3y equal to minus 3k1, minus minus get cancelled, 3 3 get cancelled, y equal to k1. Now I am going to substitute y value here, so that what I'll get means x minus 2 of k1 plus k2, k1 equal to 0. Okay, k1, k1. Now x minus 2k1 plus minus 2k1 plus k1, what I'll get means minus k1 equal to 0, x equal to k1. Totally what I'll get means capital X1, okay, equal to x comma y comma z equal to k1, k1, k1. Now I am taking common k1, so that what I'll get means 1 1 1. This is case 1. Now we are going to do case 2. Just we need to substitute in the place of lambda. Now we have to substitute 0. So that what we will get means case 2 eigen vectors corresponding to lambda equal to 0. Now after substituting lambda equal to 0, what I'll get means unit matrix 1 1 1 1 1 1 into x equal to 0. Now the same thing here also I am going to do. Same, we have to make this matrix as echelon form, and here also only row operations are, you have to use only row operation. First I am making this digit and 0 and this one. For that I am applying row 2 operation and row 3. R2 gives R2 minus R1, R3 gives R3 minus R1. So that what I'll get means 1 1 1. Here I'll get 0 0 0 0 0 0. X capital X value small x comma small x over small y. Equal to 0 0 0. Here what I have to do means just same thing, x multiply with x, y, z and equal to 0. Homogeneous equation we did in 10 plus 2. Z equal to, now I am assuming to get x value, I am assuming like z equal to k2. Oh, no, y equal to k2, z equal to k3, okay, z equal to k2, y equal to k3, so that I will get x value, okay, x plus y plus z equal to 0 from this matrix. Here x equal to minus y minus z, okay, x equal to y value minus k2, z value k3. What I get means here, capital X2 equal to x, y, z equal to minus k2 minus k3. Here y value k2, z value k3. If we simplify this one, what we will get means we are taking first k2 common, so that what I'll get means I'm taking two things common here, k2 plus k3, okay, here k2 and k3, no, minus 1 here also, minus 1. Okay, next one here also 0, here 0, k2 0 here in third row, here 1 k3, okay, that means minus k2 into minus 1, k2 into minus 1 minus k2 here, k3 into minus 1. So that what I'll get this one, minus k2 minus k3. By simplifying this, I'll get this one. If you leave like this only, no problem, they'll give marks in exam. Okay. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe down below. Meet you next video. Till that time, keep watching.